best way to experience all the wine diversity and agriculture that Sonoma County has to offer is to try it all. So today we're going to hit up as many AVAs as we can, picking up wine, produce, and goods everywhere we go. A Sonoma County scavenger hunt, if you will. Our first stop is in the Russian River Valley, an AVA that isn't protected from the ocean breezes by mountains, which means the fog rolls through the Petaluma Gap and keeps the grapes nice and cool. This extends the growing season, which, as you may know by now, is loved by Chardonnay and Pinot Noir. But this family winery produces more than just wine. Bucher Winery is also a 700-cow organic dairy farm. So before tasting, I spoke with John Bucher about his respect for ethical and responsible farming.
So we've been here a little over 60 years. Over the years, we've evolved to where we've converted our dairy to organic. And so we produce organic fluid milk for our local processor, Clover Sonoma. We have a total of 700 cows that we milk twice a day. We were one of the first dairy companies that was certified by the American Humane Association on humane treatment of animals. And that's on every carton of Clover Sonoma milk.
You know, it's amazing to see them out here treated the way they're supposed to be treated. Yeah, and we, you know, we vote with our dollars as consumers, and supporting these animals treated like this will eventually force everybody to maintain these same standards.
They're gentle giants, you know, they really are neat to hang around with. And, you know, cows are really cool in the fact that they can utilize a lot of feeds that humans can't. It's a byproduct that would go to waste, and cows can eat that, give us something high quality, high nutrition product in return. So this is how we start the calves. We call this our nursery area. Their most critical time health-wise is the first 3 to 4 weeks of their life. Think about a nursery in a hospital. By individually caring for the animals, we know what goes in, what goes out. We can monitor the temperature and ensure that they're gonna be healthy and really have a great start to life. It's really important for the calves to get the colostrum milk. That's how they get their immune system built up, is through the colostrum. So not only do they eat high quality colostrum, but they need it within a few hours. With organic dairy farming, we're not allowed to use antibiotics. So we really rely on ultra high management and care for the animals. And these individual nursery hutches are what help us do that. Once they're eating hay, they're growing, they get moved into smaller group pens, about 8 to 10, and then they get socialized there. And then from there on, they're always with their herd mates. And then once they're at least 6 months of age, then they're out into the pastures. Here we are in July, which is, you know, one of the warmest months of the year for us here in Northern California. So trying to keep the animals in a shaded area is really important. They have access to the pastures. They just don't like the heat.
Right.
If it's really hot, we're looking for a shady spot. I mean, animals are no different.
They're free to kind of do what they want.
They are waiting or being milked for no more than an hour to hour and a half in the morning, and maybe about the same, about an hour and a half a day. So think about 3 to 4 hours a day is really—
I'll take a 3-hour work day.
Yeah. So the rest of the time they're—